This year I'm going to do a series, a Christmas series. As you think about Christmas, what do you like about the Christmas season? I love certain things about Christmas. I like the food, I like the focus on Jesus, and I really love the music. I'm one of those people that can listen to Christmas music a lot, even before Christmas. I recently became acquainted with some Christmas songs I didn't know or was reminded about. Here's some of them. These are some of the newer ones I came across. Jesus Christ is Born, Wonderful, Baby Boy, Feels Like Joy, Good News, Hallelujah, Noel, Favorite Time of Year. There's some new ones that I'm enjoying. I was thinking about what I've talked about in Christmas. I like to go through series because it helps us look at the story a little bit different, what Jesus did. In the past, I did series on the glory of the Lord at Christmas, the anticipation, arrival, announcement, and adventure. Places of the Christmas story, Bethlehem, the Judean hills in Egypt, Nazareth, Jerusalem. We talked about healing of Christmas, providing peace, restoring prominence, bringing proximity, and the ABCs of Christmas joy. We talked about the star, which included hope, love, peace, and joy. And we talked about some of the Christmas character, which was generosity and relationships and being Christ-centered. Those are some of the series I've been through since being here. But this year I want to look at the Christmas story through the various parts of our body, how they react to the Christmas story. And I want to use the song kind of as an illustration, I guess, of the song, Do You Hear What I Hear? You guys know that Christmas song? Do you hear what I hear? It kind of illustrates some of these senses. We'll look back as we go through it, the effect it had on the first participants. In other words, instead of do you hear, it's did you hear? And then we'll apply some of those lessons to help us celebrate those times today. So did you hear to do you hear? I'll be sharing about today. We'll be sharing about ears that hear his glad tidings. Then we'll talk about eyes that see his glory, hearts that are filled with wonder, feet that run with the good news, and on Christmas Eve, we'll talk about hands that are raised in praise. I think it will be very interesting. But today I want to talk about ears that hear his glad tidings. And if you have your Bibles or you want to follow along up here, I want to read part of the Christmas story in Luke chapter 2, starting in verse 8. And we'll find out where this took place and how that applies to the Christmas story. Let me start reading in verse 8. It says, there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, do not be afraid. I bring you glad tidings of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests. Now, the title of my message is Ears That Hear His Glad Tidings. The reason I said that is in one translation, it says, do not be afraid, I bring you good news of great joy. It will be for all the people. But I tend to like the King James version. It sounds a little more happy to me. Glad tidings sounds a little better than good news, doesn't it? So I'm using the King James words, hearing glad tidings. George Friedrich Handel, I think I pronounced that right, the famous composer, wrote a song using those words in his famous masterpiece called The Messiah, and he said, O thou that tellest good tidings to Zion. If any of you know that song. Listen to the words of the song I told you about earlier. Do you hear what I hear? Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? A song, high above the trees, with a voice as big as the sea, with a voice as big as the sea. So today, we're going to do like that song says, we're going to celebrate ears that hear glad tidings. Do you like to hear good news? Words like, no cancer. You've just won. It's a boy or it's a girl. Those are some words of good news that you might hear. But in the Christmas story, there was some good news that was told to them, and that's what I want to start out is talking about Christmas glad tidings. Did you hear? There's many things that were spoken in this story and throughout when Jesus was born. Let's go before Jesus was born, and let's talk about the first thing that was told in this story, and that is the angel spoke to a man named Zechariah, who was a priest. In Luke 1:13, it says, the angel said to him. And then later in verse 19, the angel answered, I am Gabriel, I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and tell you this good news. What good news was he told? He was telling him that him and his wife were going to miraculously have a child. And it was going to be special. Of course, those of you who know the story know that the person he was talking about was a man named John the Baptist that was to be born. Zechariah was his father. And he came into the temple of God, and God began to speak to him through an angel about what was going to take place. Here's the lesson that we learn from that. God goes before us and prepares the way. Because before Jesus came on this earth, God sent John the Baptist to prepare the way. And God prepares the way for you and I today in many different ways for us to hear the glad tidings. The second thing that was spoken in this story is the angel announced to Mary. This is found in Luke chapter 1, verses 30 through 37. And the angel said to her, and then I can go on and quote it all, but it basically he's saying, you'll give birth to the Messiah and nothing is impossible with God. That's some good news. That's some glad tidings. The lesson for us today is this: God sometimes chooses you for great things. He chose Mary for great things. He prepares hearts to hear the good news. He did it in Jesus' time and he still does it today. He still prepares and chooses us. The third time when the glad tidings were told and they were able to hear was Elizabeth and Zechariah, after they had their baby, if you know the story. Mary became pregnant. She went to visit Elizabeth and Zechariah as she was pregnant, and they began to prophesy over Mary and the baby. Luke 1:42, and Elizabeth, it says, was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she exclaimed with a loud cry, and then she began to prophesy what was going to take place. And later in Luke 1:67, Zechariah said, he was also filled with the Holy Spirit, and he began to prophesy. The lesson is this: God graciously blesses and confirms the future for us through prophecy sometimes, and in many different ways. Aren't you glad that God tells us and we can listen and hear glad tidings? Can you imagine being there when Elizabeth and Zechariah prophesied and Mary began to hear those things? The next lesson, or the next part where they heard the glad tidings in the Christmas story, was what we just read in Luke chapter 2. And the angel said to them, do not be afraid. I bring you glad tidings, or good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Can you imagine being there and hearing that glad tidings. I know these are quick lessons, but the lesson for me is this: rejoice when you receive glad tidings. When you hear good news or glad tidings, rejoice. The shepherds did when the angels spoke to them. And maybe not the only one, but one more that I'm going to share with you this morning of glad tidings. The shepherds glorified God for what they heard. Luke 2:20 says, the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen. We're talking about ears that hear. All the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. The lesson as we look back on this is, praise God when you receive good news or glad tidings. I don't know about you, but there is enough bad news in the world today, isn't there? Everywhere you turn, you can hear people complaining. You can hear bad things happening in our country, in our world. But today I want to focus on hearing good news of glad tidings, and that is that Jesus came to this earth to be our Messiah so that all of us could receive that, hear it, receive it, and act upon it. That's, did you hear the good news? Now, what about the glad tidings today? What does that mean for us today? What do we hear that are glad tidings today? Do you hear what I hear? I want to tell you, first of all, there are things that you're going to hear in the world that are all kinds of things. The first one is this. I call it loud noises out there. These aren't always glad. I call them noises because they're not pleasant. There are often other voices or other things that are trying to get your attention that are speaking loudly in your ear. Sometimes so loud it's hard to hear other voices. They tend to speak really loud. Maybe some of you would never guess this, but I come from a family, on my dad's side especially, who all of the boys in that family have a specific nickname. They are called the Loud Brothers. And when we used to get together when I was growing up, we'd sit in my grandma's house, and it's probably, how big is it? How can I explain it? It's about half the size of the foyer out there. And we would put about 30 people in there, and we would sit wherever you could sit. And when one of the Loud Brothers would come in the house, they would get loud so everybody could hear them. Because they had to drown out everybody else's voices that were talking. Sometimes it's like that. There are loud voices out there that are getting louder and louder and louder, and they want your attention more than the person before. Sometimes they are good voices, and sometimes they are just loud. Here are some things that are trying to get your attention in your ear in society. Loud noises, the noise of the world, media, movies, the system of the world and all that goes on with it. The world is trying to speak loud enough that you will listen. Here's another loud noise out there. The cries of the lonely or the hurting or the suffering, especially when there's tragedy and bad things going on. Those are loud voices you might hear. Here's another loud noise you might hear. The nagging or aching of pain in your body or in somebody's body or in the pain of people's lives. Here's another one, the pangs of poverty or lack. People don't have enough money or they don't have enough resources or I need or I want or I'm lacking. And they let people know. And I love this word, the cacophony of comparing. You could put along with that jealousy. A cacophony is a harsh or a jarring sound. It's people who say, I should have, or they shouldn't have, or why not me? Why do they get it and I don't? That's not fair. Here's some other noises you will hear. The voices of well-meaning friends. Think back to Job, and there was comforters that meant well, and they spoke really loud, but they were loud. Think of another voice that you probably hear a lot, hopefully not too much, but the inner voice of doubt. It's a loud noise that we hear. I don't think I can do that. I'm not up to that. Another one is the echo of expectations. I ought to do this. You ought to do that. How come you're not? Those are loud noises, aren't they? We hear those things all the time. Do you listen to those loud noises? Should you be listening to all of those loud noises? Let me point you to some important noises that are speaking out there that you should be listening to. Instead of maybe some of those, here are some important words to listen to or important voices to listen to. The glad tidings of Jesus. Jesus came. We celebrate Christmas and all that that entails. That's a great voice to listen to, isn't it? If angels came and began to speak to you, would you receive that and listen to that? Here's another important word to listen to. Messages from God. Does God speak today? I believe so. I've heard Him. Sometimes He uses messengers like He did in this story. Angels that are coming to say, I am coming to tell you things. Sometimes the messengers look like you and I, and we speak to other people. But when those messages from God come, it's up to us to receive them and listen and bring them before God and say, God, what are you trying to say to me? Here's another important words to listen to, the prophetic voice of God. Sometimes God leads us through prophetic voices, like He did with Zechariah and Elizabeth. Sometimes He's trying to get us going in a certain direction, and He has people speak to us through that. And here's another one. I call it whispers from the wind of the Holy Spirit. Instead of a loud brother like I have in my family, maybe we should listen to the whispers of the Holy Spirit, right? You know what? When I grew up, they used to call that voice that when God talks to you as a still small voice. That comes from that passage in 1 Kings where God was trying to speak to the prophet. And it didn't come in the earthquake or the storm. It came in the whisper of the wind. That still small voice. Listen for that whisper of the Holy Spirit that's speaking to you. I don't think, this is my experience. Now I'm just going to share this. But generally the Holy Spirit doesn't get louder and louder than the noises. He usually just whispers. Have you ever been in a room when somebody whispers? You know what usually happens? Everybody stops and tries to hear what it is. Because it's a whisper. Many times He's trying to get our attention, and so He whispers. Are you listening? And the last voice that it's important to listen to is, I call it the voice of truth. That can fit a lot of things. First of all, it's the Bible. The Bible says, in the scripture, I think it's John 17:17, your word is truth. It says, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. When we listen to the voice of God, when we listen to the Bible, we are listening to the voice of truth. How many of you have found in your life that listening to what the words of the Bible have said have kept you on the right path and helped you more ways than you can count? Doesn't it? That's a voice we need to listen to, not those loud noises out there. You know, I think if we just took some of those things and we listened to the whisper of the Holy Spirit, we listened to the voice of truth, we listened to the prophetic voice of God or messages from God, we listened to the glad tidings of Jesus, I think we would all be better off. How many of you can say amen to that? There's a song that was sang years ago. It goes, the voice of truth tells me a different story. The voice of truth says, do not be afraid. And the voice of truth says, this is for my glory. Out of all the voices calling out to me, I forgot the rest of it, I will choose to listen and believe the voice of truth. There's one other voice I put in this, and that is the voice of praises. Like the shepherds heard from the angels. You know why it's good to put praise music on in your house? Because it's a positive, glad tidings voice to listen to. It puts us in a better frame of mind when we're listening to those voices. Let me give you some other glad tidings for us to hear today. I'm not just talking about this Christmas story. I call these the refreshing sounds to hear. What voices are good to listen to? Let me give you some examples. I know there's a zillion. How about the joy of a child? Isn't that a beautiful voice? Isn't that a good sound to hear? This last week, we got to see my little niece. She's just about 1 year old, and she is just a joy. And I'd go up to her, and I would blow on her stomach, and she wasn't sure she knew what that was like. But every time I get close to her, she would giggle, and she would like, and you know that joy that, and when a child is laughing, that's a voice we like to hear, isn't it? Here's another refreshing sound to hear: the innocence of anticipation. Don't we see that a lot at Christmas time? I can't wait. Here's another one. The hope in hearts. You know, that's not something we listen for, but did you know you can almost hear hope in hearts? Proverbs 13:12 says, hope deferred makes the heart sick, but a longing fulfilled is a tree of life. When people have hope, it's like, I can hear it. It's refreshing. Here's another one. The pleas of intercession. I love it when I can hear them praying to God for other people and other situations. Here's another refreshing sound to hear. The rhythms of rest. I know I talked a little bit before about rest. You see, the rhythms of rest speak refreshing and life into our bodies and our souls and our spirits. That's something we need to listen for. And one last there under that is the nudge of what I call new life or new things or new opportunities. Now, for some of us, new is hard. But when God is bringing us to new things, it should be refreshing and say, okay, God, there's a reason for this. I'm going to listen for that. I was thinking about, you know, we live in the Harlowton area here. One thing you can count on most every day, wind, right? The wind's blowing outside, and when we're inside, we enjoy the fact that we don't have to be in the wind all the time. To me, that's a picture of the voices outside whipping and making noise, and we can hear them. But we're inside and Jesus is speaking to us. We have noises all outside of us. But inside, Jesus is speaking to us. The world is railing outside, but God is moving and shaking inside. Now, I'm not just talking about in the church building. I'm talking about in our lives. What are you listening to? What are you hearing today? I'm going to ask three questions in response today. It's a very simple message. But the first lesson about hearing the glad tidings is, have you heard and accepted the glad tidings that Christmas represents? That's the first question. We make a big deal about Christmas so people can hear the true meaning of it. That's why we celebrate Christmas. We don't celebrate all the other things. There are some things that people like, But Christmas is not about Hallmark movies or decorations or Santa Claus or food or even just family. It is the glad tidings or the good news of Jesus Christ. Amen? That's what Christmas is about. So we tell people this: Jesus came to the earth as a baby and died for our sins so that we might have our sins paid for. We might have eternal life in heaven, and we might have life more abundantly now. Here's what Romans 10:14 says. How then can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? Will you listen to the voice of God speaking what Christmas is all about today? I know most people who are probably listening to me now have heard that and accepted it. But I would hate for one person to say, I've never heard it and accepted it. Do you hear what I hear? Do you know what Christmas is all about? Is the story of Jesus' birth glad tidings to you, or is it just another story? Or are you just non-committal or perhaps even oblivious to what it means? Here's the thing. Put it simply, if you want to receive the glad tidings, if you want to hear it and receive it, God's offering it to you today. That's the first question for all of us. Second question is this: do you hear glad tidings today? Or are you inundated and overwhelmed with the other loud noises that are out there? Would you take some time to say, God, help me to listen to the important voices, the things that you're saying, the things that you're speaking to my life, the important voices like the voice of the Holy Spirit whispering to me, or the voice of truth in the Word of God, or people speaking messages and I'm going to receive them. See, at Christmas, I think a good thing for us to do even right now is to begin to have spiritual ears and say, God, what are you speaking to me? And I want to have spiritual ears to hear. I don't know why I do this, but you know, when you're listening, sometimes if you close your eyes, you listen a little harder. Do you hear glad tidings today? And then the last question is this: what do you do with what you hear? Do you ignore the noises that are bad and only respond to the voice of God? Do you praise God for the glad tidings like the shepherds did? Do you respond in obedience by doing what God asks you to do? As Mary did, may it be as you have said. Do you receive what he speaks to you? Let me read those words to that song again. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? A song high above the trees with a voice as big as the sea. With a voice as big as the sea. Here's how I want to end the service today. There's a song that I used to listen to growing up. It's by a group called For Him. And they had a song called Voice of God. And I want you to listen to the words and ask God, are you speaking to me today, and will I listen? So let's watch the words up here and listen to this song. It's just a couple, 3 minutes long.
I hear his voice every time I hear a newborn baby cry. When I hear the sparrow singing at the dawn of morning light, I hear his voice. When I hear the thunder echo, this faithless generation, some refuse to just believe in a God they cannot see. But I have had a revelation, and I'm as sure as I can be that the God of all creation came to live inside of me. And though I have never heard his audible reply, I hear him speak unspoken words of life. Oh, 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 I hear his voice every time I hear a newborn baby cry. When I hear the sparrow sing the dawn of morning light, I hear his voice. When I hear the thunder echo through the sky, when I hear the wind come whistling through a forest full of pine, then I know, yes, I know.
Hear the voice of God today. Are you listening for glad tidings? I want everyone to bow your heads for just a moment. I asked a question earlier. Have you received the glad tidings of Jesus coming as a baby and dying for your sins? If you're here today and you've never done that, I want to give you an opportunity. Just simply raise your hand and I want to pray for you, saying, I want to receive the glad tidings of Jesus today. I want to put my faith and trust in him. Let me ask this question too. Are you listening to the voice of God? Are you aware of it? My prayer for every single one of us today is when we leave this place, we would begin to hear those things that God is speaking through his creation, through his servants, through his word. As you go into this holiday season of Jesus' birth, would you remember that the angels spoke and the shepherds listened, and would you listen for what God is speaking to you, and would you listen? So God, I pray, I'm not even going to ask who needs that because I think we all need it. God, help us to hear your voice. Help us to hear glad tidings all around us. God, help us to hear the good voices and not just the loud ones. Help us to fill ourselves with the things that you want us to hear. And maybe even if we hear that song, "Do you hear what I hear?" Lord, we would say, "Lord, what are you speaking to me?" I pray that for each and every one of us. And then, God, I pray that we would take what we have heard and we would respond accordingly, whether that's in praise or whether that's in telling others or whatever it is, Lord. Help us to hear the glad tidings. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you stand? Next week we're going to talk about eyes that see. But I would love to hear some of the things God is speaking to you that you begin to hear over the next several weeks during this holiday season. Share them with people if you need to. Praise God for them, because our ears hear lots of glad tidings. Amen? So Heavenly Father, we dismiss from this place. We give you honor and we give you praise. That we can celebrate your birth, and we can celebrate that by listening with ears that hear. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.